I was recently approached by a representative from Wondershare to do a deep video review of Filmora, which is their new name of what used to be called Wondershare Video Editor. Wondershare is a Chinese-based company, and they've sold their products under numerous different brand names. For example, this is what Wondershare Video Editor looked like. And here is Amersoft Video Editor. The same thing, just a slightly different color scheme. And here is iSkySoft Video Editor. Again, you can see these buttons here are the same. It's just a different color scheme. And back in 2010, Wondershare was banned from the Macworld forums for spamming their forums with ads for their products. They would have people come on the forum and ask a question about which is the best program to use for a particular project, such as ripping a DVD or editing videos or anything like that. And they would have someone else come on the forum with a different name but the same IP address advertise one of these products from one of Wondershare's companies. But I'm willing to give them a benefit of the doubt if they've changed their ways and improved their program since then. So I told the representative from Wondershare, I will do a review only if I'm allowed to say exactly what I think, good or bad. It'll be a true review, not just an advertisement. Just out of curiosity, I searched YouTube for reviews of the Filmora program, and I noticed most of them say that they were sponsored by the company. See, they all say this is a sponsored video. Sponsored by Wondershare Filmora. So you can trust me when I say this video is not sponsored by them, because I'm gonna say exactly what I think about this program. I've actually tried Wondershare Video Editor and its various other brand names in the past when I was searching for a Windows equivalent to iMovie 06. Now eventually I settled on Serif Movie Plus, but here is iSkySoft Video Editor, which is basically the same thing as what Wondershare Video Editor used to be, until they renamed it to Filmora, which we'll see in a moment. And you can see this opening screen here offering 16:9 or 4:3 aspect ratios and a choice of either easy mode or full feature mode. So here is the full feature mode, and when I was testing this program I noticed a critical flaw in that the timeline is fixed at 25 frames per second, and there is absolutely no way to change it. When you go to export your video, you can set it to any frame rate you want, including 29.97 or 30 frames per second. For example, here is a video I exported from iSkySoft Video Editor, and of course you can see the watermark that they put on the unregistered version, and I exported it at 30 frames per second, but as you'll see, as I stepped through this frame by frame as the camera was panning, every fifth frame was repeated. For example, these two frames are identical. Then we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's again a repeated frame. So you get this stuttery motion because when you're editing your video, it scales it down to 25 frames per second. And then when you export it, it converts it back to 30 frames per second, which means 5 frames per second are repeated. That's not a problem if your video was natively recorded at 25 frames per second, such as PAL video used in Europe and other parts of the world, but if you're using NTSC video, which was recorded at 29.97 or 30 frames per second, and you go to export it, you'll get those repeated frames, which basically makes this program unusable. So that's one thing I was most interested in, seeing if this new Wondershare Filmora video editor fixed that problem. So we'll go to open it up, and it gives us again the choice of 4:3 or 16:9, and easy mode or full feature mode. And here it is, very similar, just a slightly redesigned interface, more flat look that's more stylish these days. So we'll go to import a video here. That same one I was working on in iSkySoft Video Editor. And we'll drag it into our timeline. And there's one thing I noticed about this new version. You can't use the arrow keys to step frame by frame. It just absolutely does not work. So you have to go in and drag the little marker here with your mouse. And if we zoom all the way in, we can see that it's also based on 25 frames per second. Here you can see the frame counter as I move my mouse, 23, 24, and then the next frame is 0, so again, it's based on 25 frames per second. Nonetheless, I'm going to export my video, and they do give you a choice of different resolutions and bit rates, which is good. I'm going to choose 29.97 frames per second, just like I did with the iSkySoft video editor. And I'm going to see how it comes out. So here's the video exported by Filmora. Again, you can see it has a big watermark on it for the unregistered version. And as I step through it, I'm surprised to see that there are no repeated frames. So I guess somehow, even though the timeline is clearly still based on 25 frames per second, even if you import a 30 frame per second video into it, it manages to export properly 30 frames per second video with no repeated frames as I'm stepping through it here. So I'm going to try importing a 60 frame per second video into Filmora and exporting it and see if it preserves all the frames correctly. I have a video here that is 60 frames per second, or actually 59.94. I have it loaded into Movie Plus, and this is a video recorded using a lossless codec called Lagarith, which this program has no problem supporting. You can see the aspect ratio is incorrect, but in Movie Plus, I can just go to Properties, go to Media Properties, and set the aspect ratio to 16:9, and now we have our correct aspect ratio. Now, loading that same clip into Wondershare, you can see we have a problem. It's vertically flipped. And also, there is no way I can see to change the aspect ratio. I can go to Edit here, and I can do a vertical flip to make it the right side up, but there is no way to change the aspect ratio. But nonetheless, let's see if it exports it properly at 60 frames per second. You can see it does have an option for 59.94 frames per second, so that's what I will use as I export this video in Filmora. So we'll see how it turns out. So here's the video I exported from Filmora at 59.94 frames per second. And it did preserve all the frames without repeating any of them. You can see as I scroll through it in Serif Movie Plus, you can see it goes up to 59 and then the next frame is 0. So it did preserve all 60 frames per second with no repeated frames. I just discovered in Filmora it is possible to step through your video frame by frame, but not using the arrow keys. Instead, you use the comma and period keys. I know there's another video editor that uses these keys. I think it's CyberLink Power Director, so I guess they wanted it to work more like that. But they still should have supported using the arrow keys, like the older versions and like pretty much every other video editor. But now to step through your video frame by frame, you just have to use period and comma. So that's not as bad as I initially thought it would be. But still, there's no way to change the aspect ratio of your video clip, which is a big problem for me, because a lot of the time I do need to do that. So Wondershare Filmora is not a major change compared to their previous video editor. They basically just redesigned the look of it a little bit. And they did fix that frame rate problem of it being fixed to 25 frames per second. So that is a definite improvement. But otherwise, it still has the same limited features as the previous version, some of which I've mentioned. And of course, in the unregistered version, you get this huge watermark on your video. And if you do want to purchase Wondershare Filmora, the price is $29.99 per year for a 1-year license, or $49.99 for a lifetime license. But if we look at the program I personally recommend, Serif Movie Plus X6 is the latest version. It's $29.99 with free shipping on Amazon.com, and you get it on a physical DVD to install on your computer. It's not just a download. It actually costs more here to download as compared to getting the disc version. Of course, this price is subject to change, but as of right now, Wondershare costs more for a more limited program than Serif Movie Plus. So it's obvious I'm gonna stick with my recommendation for Serif Movie Plus.